Yeah, that's really not clear at this point, Jen. The charge is reckless second-degree murder. Investigators are still considering the possibility that an incident unfolded between the two men earlier that night. Daniel Langlois' longtime girlfriend says it was a careless act that killed the father of her children. The pain, 6 months later, still palpable.
It was a cold, snowy night in Manchester, December 27th. 25-year-old Daniel Langlois was driving an SUV near Jane and Nashua Streets when he was shot, one time in the back of the head. Today, the alleged gunman faced a judge and a courtroom filled with Langlois' large, loving family.
The investigation has been long and detailed and pretty arduous. Our office, the Manchester Police Department, and also the U.S. Attorney's Office in Concord have all been working together to bring this case to a point where we could finally make an arrest.
26-year-old Jesus Fernandez was arrested Sunday night. The news reaching the victim's family this morning.
It's good that it's all finally starting to get taken care of. It still doesn't bring him back.
Katrina Warren and Daniel Langlois had been together for 7 years. They have a daughter. And on the night Daniel died, Katrina had had an ultrasound revealing that a son was on the way.
It's just rough and hard to know that he's never going to be able to hold his son and watch my kids go to school and be there for all their milestones in life.
Named after his deceased father, this six-week-old wears a onesie that says, "I love my daddy." Katrina says he looks just like his father, which is a comfort to this young mother.
Never would imagine in a million years that this is going to be our life and that my kids would suffer this much.
As for the man charged with pulling the trigger, Katrina says there is no connection between her Daniel and Fernandez.
No, I've never met him. I've never seen him. Just carelessness, really.
The complaint lists Fernandez's address as Wilson Street here in Manchester, but investigators say Fernandez splits his time between here in New Hampshire and New York. He was not arrested here. Fernandez being held without bail at the Valley Street Jail. He will be back in court July 27th for a probable cause hearing. We're live in the newsroom, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.